Hi, John here. This video is about how I go about cleaning my solar panels with a water-fed pole and the equipment that I use. Plus, at the end of the video, I've sort of split it into two parts. First part is the doing. Second part is all the equipment and bits and bobs that I have. I guess the first thing to chat about is, do you need to clean your solar panels? Because I see a lot of people in forums and on what have you, social media, saying, oh, I don't need to clean my panels because the rain cleans them. Well, that's a bit of a fallacy. Then whilst they might be clean now, with time, if you don't clean them over the years, they will become obviously dirty and dirtier, and potentially you'll get a build-up of green algae, which then in turn will promote lichen growth. So here are our panels, and you can see they're quite dirty, even though I cleaned them last year, which was actually the first time I had cleaned them. But if you look on the left there, there's our neighbours' panels. They've never cleaned theirs. They had theirs installed at the same time in 2011. And you can see at the top row there all the build-up of lichen. And I've done a separate video on lichen, how it comes, how it forms, blah, 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 blah. So I'll put a link to that up the top corner if you want to go and look at that. But this was our panels last year. They were very, very dirty and had a big build-up of lichen on them. These are the original panels which were installed in 2011 and had never been cleaned. Now that they are clean, I just need to do them once, maybe twice a year, just to get the build-up of bird poo and dust and other bits and pieces. And they are still very dirty even after sort of 6-8 months of not being cleaned. So to those people that say you never need to clean the panels, invariably most people will need to, and over the passage of time you will find that if you don't clean your panels, you're most likely going to get an algae build up in the first place, and then second, that will then form into lichen, which is a nightmare to get off, so you don't really want to do that. So preventative maintenance is a good thing. So this is me getting ready for cleaning the panels. It takes about half an hour to do them, bringing round the water-fed pole. And then bringing round the two resin-filled vessels. Talk more about those later. I've got two of them. Because our water is particularly hard where we live, and a lot of chalk in it, a lot of suspended solids in there. I'm just turning that one round because it's got to flow in and out on the actual bottle. Just connecting them up, two in parallel. Connecting up the hoses. This is a standard gardener pole, which we're going to talk more about later. Turning on the water, up the ladder. You'll see the ladder's nice and safe, so secured at the base. And then it's got a support rest, which rests on the roof space, roof tiles, rather than resting on the guttering. Onto the roof. This is the brush head I use for cleaning the solar panels. I use it exclusively for that. And it's got a water feed system over the top on that little bracket, which sprays water over the top. It's connected to a four-way, so I've got two nozzles spraying through the head, and then two using the overhead spray bar. Quite straightforward, giving it a clean, and then once you've cleaned them down, you lift the brush off the panel and then create a cascade of water to let everything run off. Now luckily I've got a single story roof, so I can stand safely on that and easily get to the panels. If you don't have a single story roof, you will need a longer pole to be able to get to your panels if they're on your roof space. I bought my own system rather than relying on the window cleaner to do it, because I thought, well, whilst the cost of it is initially high, over a couple of years of doing my own solar panels, plus doing my own windows and all my soffits and guttering and what have you, it'll pay for itself, which indeed it has. So this is the model I have. It's Gardner, which is a UK designed and manufactured product. Obviously, there are lots of others available, but I can only speak for the one that I use. And I found it great, no problems at all. It's very lightweight, easy to maintain and hold, and it's well built. It has a tube connecting it, so one end goes up through the pole up to the brush head, and then the other end fits into standard hose lock fitting. The big foam ball there is to protect the fitting at the end there, because it tends to get banged about as you move. Also very useful is an inline valve, an on-off switch, which again has one of those big foam protected balls there, because it tends to get banged about. You can see there it's got a bit scuffed already on the plastic handle. Head-wise, so this is the head I use for the solar panels with the overhead spray bar on. I've got three styles of brush head. So there's the one on the left there with the wider bristles and the bristles that go around the side. And this is great for doing white work, guttering, fascias, soffits, all that kind of thing. It fits around the corner and you can get good angles in those difficult to get nooks and crannies. This is the standard one I use for the windows. We've got leaded light windows at the front, so you're careful on what you choose. You don't want something that's too abrasive or too hard a bristle, so this is a soft bristle option. It's worth considering the width of your windows. Whatever your smallest window is probably the ideal brush width. And if you go onto the Gardner website, not only can you obviously buy all the pole and what have you. So here's the telescopic poles, and the SLX22 is the one we have, as I said. But you can go to brushes, and then there's a very handy brush guide there that you can have a look at, and it will recommend what size and purpose it's used for. So it's always worth a read. You can download that as well as a PDF. The other thing which is important, which I said about, which are the resin-filled containers to give you pure water. So this here demonstrates our tap water. I'm using a device called a TDS monitor, total dissolved solid monitor, and it'll measure the dissolved solids that are in the water. And what happens is when the water dries, those total dissolved solids remain, and that gives you your spots, your water spots. And if you've ever washed a car with tap water and let it dry, you'll know what those sort of white milky spots are, and they're really difficult to get rid of once you've got them. So our tap water comes in at 3, 4, 5 parts per million. Not ideal for cleaning windows, solar panels, cars. Once they've gone through the two resin filters, so this is an example here, so out the, straight out the hose, end of the hose, pop in the device, and it comes out at 2 parts per million. And that effectively is pure water. I think it's anything under 3 is pure water. And what that means is that once the water dries and evaporates, it won't leave any spots, because it's got no damn TDS, no total dissolved solids. And you can get the resin filters, there's various websites. I use these people, which are very good. You can buy the canister, pre-filled or empty, and fill it yourself. I got the ones with filled, and they also sell all the resin media as well if you want. I probably use one bag over 18 months. Handy tip is to get a funnel, because it makes it filling very much easier. And here's the two filters, containers, canisters, whatever. The reason I have two is because our water is so hard and it gives it a sort of a double hit. And what I do is the first one is the first one in line, so that goes straight from the tap, the outside tap. and then the second one is the second one in line, which then goes to the water-fed pole, or the if I'm doing the car, the power washer. And when I test the water, which I do on a regular basis, and it's gone over 3 parts per million, I know to change one of the filters. So what I do, the first one, which will be the first one it meets as the water comes in, will be the most used, as it were. So I empty that one and put fresh in, and I move that to number 2 in position, and the number 2 position I move to number 1 position. So basically just rotating them to increase the life on them, because the second one won't be as contaminated as the first one, so we can get some extra life out of that. So that's how I work. Anyway, there you go. That's a very quick overview of how I clean the solar panels, why I clean them, and the equipment that I use. Any questions, give me a shout down below in the comments and I'll pick them up. All right, thanks for watching.